The Queen is currently enjoying her summer break at Balmoral in Scotland, but royal fans can enjoy a series of special events at her Norfolk estate while she's away. Sandringham's official Twitter account shared details of its upcoming concerts over the bank holiday weekend. Jules Holland with special guests will appear on Saturday, the 28th of August, while the English Symphony Orchestra will be performing the proms on Sunday, the 29th of August. Ever fancied a snoop around Sandringham, the Queen's, albeit reportedly haunted, Norfolk residence? Well, you're in luck, because this weekend the monarch is opening the grounds of Sandringham to the public for a series of special events. The Norfolk estate, which also houses Kate Middleton and Prince William's country residence Anne Mahal, is where the monarch typically spends her winters, hosting her grandchildren and great-children for Christmas. Though the COVID-19 pandemic put a stop to a big royal family Christmas last year, the Queen traditionally stays at Sandringham until 6 February, the anniversary of her father King George VI's death, before moving on to her other primary residencies for the spring and summer. But that doesn't mean Sandringham will stand empty while the monarch's away. Yes, the Queen may be currently busy pranking tourists and walking her corgis during a well-earned break at Balmoral, but Sandringham are offering a packed schedule of exciting events in celebration of the coming August bank holiday weekend. According to Sandringham's official Twitter account, Jules Holland with special guests will appear on Saturday, the 28th of August, while the English Symphony Orchestra will be performing the proms on Sunday, the 29th of August. Concertgoers are invited to make the most of HRH's incredible Royal Parkland scenery by bringing their own picnics, though catering and a fully licensed bar will also be available within the concert area. The Queen is a known lover of live music, so much so, in fact, that she begins every day with a live bagpipe serenade outside her bedroom window, so the special events doubtlessly had the full royal stamp of approval. And to make the most of the stunning scenery of the Royal Parkland, guests can bring their own picnics, while catering and a fully licensed bar will also be available within the concert arena. The estate holds many events throughout the year, including country fairs, theatre performances and the Run Sandringham 10K. The monarch, 95, typically spends her winter break at her Sandringham estate and is usually joined by members of her family over the Christmas period. While the royals did not attend the traditional Christmas Day church service last year due to the pandemic, the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge's eldest children, Prince George and Princess Charlotte, made their debuts in 2019. Her Majesty traditionally stays at Sandringham until 6 February, the anniversary of her father King George VI's death. Although throughout the pandemic, the Queen has mostly resided at Windsor Castle. During her 69-year reign, the Queen has attended hundreds of musical performances. To mark her Golden Jubilee in 2002, the gardens of Buckingham Palace were used to stage a public concert for the first time, featuring performances by Queen, Elton John, and Shirley Bassey. But perhaps her best gig yet is still to come, as a concert is scheduled to be staged in the gardens of Buckingham Palace in celebration of Her Majesty's Platinum Jubilee in 2022.